Welcome, everybody. So we are at the last and the final panel discussion of this Indo-French seminar on women in science. And this is a rather important panel where we will discuss the gender equality plans and policies. So taking the input from the two other panels. And I feel this is the right platform, given the history of the French, for the fight and the struggle, the deed. And from the Indian side, we have actually a great tradition where the learning is associated with the female, with the goddesses. You can see the book and the pen, but we thought all that comes from a woman, not really a man. So traditionally, we were all set being thinking in this way, but down the line, thing disappeared, and that's why we are having this discussion. And let me start with a few comments that we have been discussing about how to make the parents, parent-in-laws. I think Catherine even mentioned the boyfriend. So we need public awareness, public attention. So far, people have actually appreciated this issue of underrepresentation, but it's primarily in politics, business, public administration. While this existence of gender bias in science and technology has long been underrated, and with these two other panel discussions, we have actually established that science is no exception, and several of the panelists, with the help of clear data, has shown that this is indeed true. And most importantly, the women tend to disappear as we progress from lower to higher level of scientific careers. And we all appreciate, as a scientist, that has a tremendous negative impact because we are losing half of the population in growth of a particular field. So that's the important point. And policy efforts, fortunately, we will have several of the policymakers and from the representations from different funding agencies. We had a few already, but we are going to have more. That this has been appreciated by many of the institutions and organizations, both in Europe and in India. And the changes we see today, I think it was mentioned that we are better than in terms of what our mothers used to do. Our mothers were better in terms of what our grandmothers used to do. So definitely there is progress. However, there is enough scope of improvement. And what I gather from the two other panel discussion, first is awareness, supporting all programs with awareness raising activities, outreach program. This has been actually discussed a lot. Interaction with role models to inspire people, active mentoring of female young students, explaining the expectations and demands in scientific profession. I think yesterday it was mentioned, we should also tell them the fun part of it. One has to enjoy doing science. It is just not some responsibility given to you. It's your passion, and that has to be highlighted. Second one, that came out of two of the panel discussion is promoting women in leadership position. That's very important to change the scenario. Strengthening women's visibility, their role in communication, giving them the confidence that they can communicate well, they can express themselves, don't be shy and be at one corner of the room. Increasing women's influence in innovation and science-society relationship, which I think is linked to the first point, recruiting and retaining the next generation of women. I don't think this has been touched upon in a great detail, but I hope in this panel discussion it will be done. The role of search committees and funding agency. I think one of the great idea, I think Rohini mentioned sometime, if she is still in the audience, is to actually have a meeting of the directors, the institute directors, the awareness program. that the search committee, the funding committees, must be aware and vigilant about the bias, even if it is an unconscious bias, that takes place when you are reviewing your candidates. So with that, let me introduce my Indian panelist, Dr. V.K. Anitha, who is professor and dean of the, maybe you can raise your hand, from the National Institute of Advanced Studies in Bangalore. She is going to talk about statistics of women in the STEM discipline, important questions with regard to representations and levels, mentoring, leadership challenges and opportunities, some of the points I have actually highlighted, policy directions. The second Indian panelist is Dr. Mukesh Kumar, whom you all know by this time. He's director of CEFIPRA. He's going to talk about a very important point, reasons for making choice in science, strength and weakness. I think this is a very, very important point. Role of government and society, activities and programs of CEFIPRA, which he already mentioned some of it on the first day, but he is going to elaborate more on this.